Hello and welcome to the third part of my video series on building a diesel space heater for the animal house. In the first two videos, I introduced you to the new vevor diesel space heater. I introduced and showed you how I installed the China heater in the heating box. In this video, I would like to show you how I install the electrical system and then attach the complete heating box from the outside to the garden house. I will show you how I install the warm air duct. I will install and reconnect the circulation from the house to the heating box. When, how I do it, and if the diesel heater works, so stay tuned, it's about to start. The photovoltaic island system is just not strong enough to provide the animal house with sufficient power for the electric heater, even in winter. To supply, the batteries did not last long enough. For this reason, I decided to build a heating box. For this, I installed a diesel space heater, China heater from vevor. In the last videos, I simply showed you how I connect the fittings for the warm air, the combustion air, the exhaust, and the circulation installed in the heating box. I have also installed the transformer that provides the 12V power supply. At the moment, the power cable is only temporarily connected to a normal 220V cable. The 220V, the cable has a Schuko plug on the other side. It is supposed to be connected to the battery later, will be connected to my PV system. This way, the heating, apart from the diesel, largely self-sufficient. However, the heating is no longer so susceptible to the dark season. Today, I would like to start perfecting these passages. I like the hole with the cable. Not at all. For this reason, I will install this waterproof connector. On one side, the plug is firmly mounted on the heating box, and on the other side, the cable has a mobile plug. I can plug it in or unplug it at any time. This allows the mobile heating box to be used for other purposes. For example, for camping or caravanning, I simply take the heating box with me and use it for the roof tent or the motorhome. There, it heats autonomously. Besides the installation of the connection plugs, for the power supply, I also want the remote control, which is still currently installed in the animal house at the front of the diesel space heater. The remote control has a temperature control, allows me to set the temperature in the birdhouse to an accuracy of 30°C. The diesel space heater will then regulate itself automatically. For this, I need to cut the cable and connector. Build a passage through the heating box into the garden house. There, I will install the remote control permanently and reconnect it. Then I can control the heating from the inside. Additionally, I also need to build the pipe connection for the ventilation. Somehow, it has to be done. Heating air coming into the house. You can see here the empty conduits through which the cables will run should be protected. The air vent moves air in the house is neatly organized. Here are still plenty of other things that I need for this project. The animal house has an outdoor aviary, and inside I have an area of approximately 9-10 meters of floor space that I need to heat. I will not install the heating box inside because the diesel space heater is too loud for that. Also, the risk of the diesel smell entering the risk of the house being penetrated is too high for me. For this reason, I will place the mobile heating box on mount on the back of the house. I will screw the diesel space heater to the back in such a way that I will also secure the aluminum box against theft. A power supply. I have already built it. The socket receives power directly from the inside. Nothing from the heating system should be visible in the animal house. The birds have their area in the upper part of the house, while the rodents live on the ground. The electric heater fan. The one I am currently using has an integrated thermostat and is additionally supported by this manually controlled thermostat at the socket. This also works after a power outage. I have installed an additional switch here to turn the outdoor socket on and off. My goal is to banish these devices from the animal house and instead install two ventilation inlets. To install once on the left and once on the right. On one side, the warm air should flow into the air will be blown into the house, and on the other side, the room air should be sucked out again. The air is directed into the heater there and reheated. It refrains from drawing in cold fresh air. This would be necessary at the cold temperatures of below 0°, completely new to the desired temperature be heated. Through the circulation, the air has a higher supply temperature, and I can save on heating costs. The heating box is attached to the back of the house. The box is mounted in such a way that the lid can be opened easily. The gap is large enough so that the lid remains open by itself. The heating box is initially secured with screws temporarily. I will further secure the construction later with special screws to prevent theft. On the underside, you can see the construction, the console, a cross brace and the longitudinal brace. I have decoupled them with rubber discs. This way, they can vibrations from the diesel engine are not transmitted into the house. I will now connect the hose to connect for the air. The angle should be as small as possible to go directly into the house to get inside. The same will be done again on the other side. There, the warm air comes in, out, and then blown in here. A hole is drilled here, and on the inside it will then be the ventilation grill set the ventilation duct directed back outside, plugged into the heating box. Then the vevor diesel heater is already functioning. In circulation mode, I will temporarily reconnect the electrical system for now, and then the animals will already have a warm home tonight. Before I continue with the installation, I will continue, but at this point there is a short pause with a request to you. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up now. I would be really happy about that. If you haven't done so yet, click the subscribe button in the bottom right corner. Don't miss my new videos. Please also check the description under the video. There you will find all the materials that I used for my diesel heating box. Right? Leave me a comment and give me feedback on what you think about this project. I respond to everyone. You know that. But enough talking for now. Let's continue with the installation of the ventilation pipes. I have installed the connections for the power supply and the remote control in the box. These plug contacts are attached to box with three screws. On the inside, I carefully secured the plugs again with nuts and tightly connected the cables in three junction boxes with utmost precision and attention to detail, ensuring everything was secure and properly aligned. The cable from the power supply runs into this box and connects to the transformer with the WAGO terminals. Connected. The cable from the transformer then continues to the heating. In the third box, the cable for the remote control, which is currently just simply plugged in at the back and securely connected to ensure proper connection. I still have the counterpart lying here. The remote control was attached with double-sided tape. Tape stuck to the front. I cut it off with the utility knife and wanted to originally glue the remote control with silicone to the lid of another junction box. This way I can connect the cables directly under the remote control. But I have to say, I am a little positively surprised. There are these holes on the back to the hang the remote control directly on the wall with screws. This makes the installation easy for me, significantly more elegant. The connection plug is currently still closed. Here I will very carefully cut the cable and securely create the connection to the new cable safely and efficiently in the junction box. I installed the cable channel on the back of the house and the two cables packed inside. The power supply and the control cable are firmly connected to the box. And on the inside, I secured the cables with cable ties. There must be order. The space in the heating box is large enough to place a car battery here and an additional tank, because with these 5 liters, I might just get by for 2 to 3 days. Wants to install a tank from boat building that is slightly larger and can hold up to 20 liters. Inside the birdhouse, it is now pleasantly warm. The control of the diesel heater can from the inside. I removed the display from the heater and attached it to this. Installed a junction box. The display is secure and the birds are already using it as a sleeping place. With the control module, I can individually set the temperature and adjust it to my desired temperature. If I don't want to go into the house, I can of course also use the remote control for that. Use a click on the plus and I can increase the temperatures. The remote control has a range of about 10 to 20 mem. For me, that is completely sufficient. I have the air outlets installed carefully below the shelf for the birds. The intake draws the air from the house into the heating box, sucks in and continues to warm up. The warm air is then blown into the house from this side. My mobile heating box with the diesel heater from vevor is now running a week consistently through. The temperatures are particularly back down at night, dropped to about 10 degrees to 11 degrees. With the heating level 2 of the 8 kilo of diesel heater, I was able to keep the temperature here inside stable at around 110 degrees to 111 degrees. The consumption, it has settled at approximately 0.2 to 0.3 liters of diesel per hour. I will operate the system with heating oil in the future. This will further reduce costs. I have connected my mobile heating box to the birdhouse and the diesel heater is working. They perform their service confidently. The consumption is manageable, and I can think about how I will continue to decouple the housing. The clicking of the pump is quite audible inside. What else are you interested in? What should I show you in another video? Would you like me to show you the heating box in a video? Just give me some feedback and write to me below. The comment section, what interests you and what else you would like to see. If you like my video, please let me know down in the comments. If you liked it, then give me a thumbs up. That helps me and my channel to grow. It also helps me if you use my product links for your replica. Just take a look at them. The video description below the video. There, I have included the diesel heater, the box, and all other. I have linked the components I used for you. Just click and purchase directly. Same. Price for you and a small commission for me and my channel. I'm done for today. My 3 videos on building the diesel heater for the birdhouse in the garden are completed. When? If you want to see more, leave me a comment. Take care and see you in the next project. Ciao.